Hi, I'm James, and today we're going to be talking about text delay. What is it? Why it's way better than the default text animator. And we're going to be talking about the nuts and bolts, how it works, and how it could be better. Text delay exists because I wanted to apply a transformation to my text layer, and I want to delay that transformation per character. After Effects has an inbuilt text or character animator, as you know, that can essentially do this, but the controls are super clunky and it can do very basic easing, and that's about it. If you want to add a physics expression, if you want to add ease and whiz, if you want to add flow, you can't do that. You're restricted to this one slider that is basically smoothness. Text delay exists to fix that one issue. So firstly, a bit of a disclaimer. Text delay is a bit of a hack. To separate the characters, text delay is using a very ghetto method, since there's no inbuilt method for the plugin to know which character is what. And so it's essentially drawing a little box around each character to separate them. And that's why you need to use the threshold slider. If the characters are too close together, then you're gonna have to tweak the threshold to make sure that the plugin is correctly separating each character. Because unfortunately there's no way, even though After Effects, I know, internally knows which character is which, it doesn't provide that, it doesn't expose that information to me, the developer. So that's why we have to use this ghetto method, and it's why sometimes you'll have to do a little bit of setup with text delay. But with that said, how does text delay work? Essentially, you apply it to your text layer, and then if your text layer transitions to the left, the plugin, kind of like Cartoon Moblur, takes every other character and then reverses the transform. So it looks like only one character is moving at a time. If you scale down your text layer, then text delay takes the characters and scales them back up. A problem occurs if your layer has motion blur. For example, if you've transformed the text and it's getting motion blur because you've moved the text, and then the plugin has shifted some of the characters back, those characters still have motion blur applied, but they appear as if they're not moving. As a wise old man once said, you can't unmilk a cow. So once the motion blur has been applied, we can't fix that. So the way we get around that is you don't have motion blur turned on the layer. And then for the one character that's actually moving, the plugin will apply its own motion blur. So at least the motion blur is now correct. This same sort of issue happens when a user was like, this plugin is cool, can you add opacity? And I was like, yeah, I can, that sounds pretty easy. But then I thought, if you have the layer at 100% opacity and then keyframe it down to zero opacity, now the entire layer is invisible. But I wanted to delay that, so I wanted most of the characters to still be visible. And once the layer is invisible, there's nothing you can do. So to get around that, we've added another opacity slider, which is not the master opacity of the layer, but just a slider that you can animate. And essentially, once that's zero opacity, only the characters that should be affected are invisible or transparent. That's another complication we had to overcome. A new feature that is currently unreleased is we have hue shifting. So now we've got an angle slider, which controls the hue of your layer. And if you animate that, you can then delay it. So for example, if any of you are old enough to have played the game RuneScape and you could type that wavy text that's sort of like rainbowing, you can now create that inside of text delay. And the reason that feature exists is literally because I wanted to create the RuneScape animated text. And I thought, actually, this is actually pretty difficult to do, but text delay is perfect for it. We created a promo video of Matt in Fortitude Valley, which is where our old office was, acting out a RuneScape scenario, and we'll show that now. It's pretty embarrassing, but yeah. So hopefully we'll be releasing that feature soon, but it's pretty much only useful for RuneScape text. I'm not sure if you'll be able to come up with an actual proper use case for that. Going forward, I've been contacting Adobe saying, hey, I know After Effects can separate the characters perfectly. Can you give that information to the developer? Which they haven't yet, but fingers crossed, because that would allow the plugin to perfectly separate each character instead of you, the user, having to sometimes tweak it. If you've got some other ideas for how to make this plugin better or some new features, let me know. Don't send me a support ticket, and enjoy text delay.